I know that I have been covering Indonesian volcanoes a lot lately, and I mean a lot. Just there truly is a lot of activity ongoing in the country, with specifically a bit more than usual at multiple volcanoes since this November began. Well, adding to this, there has been a further change and additional two volcanoes in the country, resulting in both of their alert levels being raised. This occurred on November 10th when the Lokon volcano on the island of Sulawesi was raised from yellow to orange, and when on the same day the Rokatenda volcano, which is also known as the Paluweh volcano, had its alert level raised from green to yellow on the island of Paluweh. Rokatenda, unlike volcanoes to the south such as Kelamutu and Luatobi, which are in the main volcanic arc, is instead considered to be a back arc volcano. Rokatenda could best be considered as a lava dome complex volcano, with its recent eruptions and summit areas consisting of many overlapping andesitic lava domes, which can each be up to 850 meters wide. These lava domes during eruptions produce frequent partial collapses, giving way to building pressure underneath them, which results in pyroclastic flows and what is known as a Merapi-type volcanian eruption. Due to the fairly small size of the island it is situated on, with no point being more than 4,070 meters or 13,353 feet away from its summit, pyroclastic flows generated by its eruptions have resulted in multiple deadly events. This has occurred in three of its nine historical eruptions since 1600, specifically in 1964 and 2013 due to pyroclastic flows, and due to a landslide generated by an eruption which created a 10-meter or 33-foot-high tsunami in 1928, which itself wiped out more than half of the island's population. So, what exactly caused this volcano, which has not erupted since 2013 and has not been at a raised alert level since 2016, to have its color code raised? Specifically due to the report of a strong sulfur smell from locals. This strong sulfur smell likely indicated the increased presence of hydrogen sulfide gas, one of the big three distinctively volcanic gases shallow magma can produce. While some eruptions at Rokatenda occur with little or no warning, many of its eruptions occur with a distinct progression of events beforehand. Specifically, increased gas emissions, a sudden die-off of vegetation where an eventual eruption will occur, and then an increase in volcanic earthquakes. So, while we now may be entering the first stage before another eruption occurs, it could also simply be a mistaken report from specific weather conditions causing normal volcanic gas emissions to accumulate at elevated levels in or near a specific settlement. In other words, the human perception of gas is not a great indicator, but should be still taken into consideration. In contrast, the change of the Lokon volcano 1,125 kilometers to the north-northeast on November 10th was a bit more significant. There, its number of volcanic earthquakes have rapidly jumped since Halloween, going from an average of 2.8 earthquakes a day in their prior 11 days to 43 a day between October 31st and November 9th. Then, on November 10th, 130 earthquakes occurred, a rate which is 4,513% higher than normal. This is what finally caused Lokon's alert level to be raised, as there is now a distinct possibility that its Tompaluan crater could soon produce a phreatic eruption. This crater last produced a small phreatic eruption on June 13th of 2023. So, based on all of this information, where would I place these two volcanoes on my opinion-based volcanic unrest scale, and how does this compare to the Aya volcano? In my opinion, I would place Rokatenda as a 2 and Lokon at a 5, with Aya being at a 6 for comparison. As a final note, I want to remind everyone that for context of Indonesia's 105 active or potentially active volcanoes, that 24 of these, or 22.86% of the nation's volcanoes, are at a raised alert level, with 9 of these being actively erupting. I would like to thank my new YouTube channel member Ed Gilman for supporting my work.